पुण्यासह राज्यातील शहरांमध्ये सुरू होणारे मेट्रो प्रकल्प पुढील 10 वर्षांमध्ये पांढरे आठते ठरतील त्याचा थेट बोजा राज्याच्या तिजोरीवर पडणार आहे असे राज्याचे जलसंपदा मंत्री जयंत पाटील यांनी म्हटलंय.
डेक्कन एज्युकेशन सोसायटीच्या बृहन महाराष्ट्र कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स तर्फे नृसिंह उर्फ राजाभाऊ चितळे यांच्या स्मरणार्थ भारतीय अर्थव्यवस्थेतील महाराष्ट्राचे योगदान या विषयावर आयोजित व्याख्यानात पाटील बोलत होते. सोसायटीचे अध्यक्ष डॉ शरद कुंटे, बीएमसीसीचे प्राचार्य चंद्रकांत रावळ यावेळी उपस्थित होते. पाटील म्हणाले, नागपूरमध्ये 1000 कोटी खर्च करून मेट्रो सुरू केली पण त्यातून मोजकेच प्रवासी प्रवास करतात. ज्यांनी मेट्रो उभारली असे केंद्रीय दळणवळण मंत्री नितीन गडकरी दुचाकीने प्रवास करतात. यावरूनच स्पष्ट होते की मेट्रो शहरांची किती गरज आहे. पुण्यामध्ये मेट्रोचे थांबे विचारपूर्वक उभारले पाहिजेत, तरच नागरिकांना मेट्रोचा फायदा घेता येईल. BRT प्रकल्पाचा फायदा अंमलबजावणी झाली नसल्याने पुणेकरांना झाला नाही. मेट्रो पुणेकरांना सरकारला फायद्याची ठरेल असा आशावाद त्यांनी व्यक्त केला. जलद गतीने वाढणाऱ्या शहरांचा ताण पायाभूत सुविधांवर पडत आहे, त्यामुळे शहरीकरण सरकार समोरील मोठे आव्हान आहे असेही त्यांनी स्पष्ट केले.
आय स्टील रिमेंबर इन 2004 to 2014 इन बिटवीन देर वॉज अ रूल ऑफ अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी. He was also very liberal in his attitude, his approach. So nothing went wrong. The economy flourished. And after that, Manmohan Singh became Prime Minister, who founded the liberal economics theory in India. In his regime also, India growth was very fast. After his 10 years tenure, we have seen Mr. Narendra Modi's 5 years regime, where the expectations have gone so high that this government's economic steps or his ideas are not matching to the aspirations of Indian youths. Whenever you see the gap, there is dissatisfaction level in the country. Now in India, everybody, if you go to any urban city, you will see we are building metros all over India. You go to any rural area, people want something like road. Expectations are more. The point is the expectations have grown. So the person living in the rural area also expects that the road has to reach to his village. People, all of you are staying in Pune. Now you are looking forward for metro, I hope so. And cities like Nagpur, cities like Nasik, they are also looking forward for the new infrastructure. So the Indian economy or the state of Maharashtra has now bigger challenges and they need to play their role very carefully. All the economic solutions are not acceptable to masses immediately. In last 2 and 3 budgets which Indian government presented, people are not so happy with the government's approach towards infrastructure and towards the growth of industry. I remember I had gone to World Bank way back in 2006-2007, and after I've visited all the areas of World Bank, all the departments, one Indian officer came and said that in the evening we want to have tea with you. Will you be able to spare some time? It is very important for Maharashtra. Yes, of course we can. And we met in the evening. About 8 to 10 Maharashtra and Indian officers met me and gave me a docket in my hand. And he said, if you go back and do this, implement this, then Indian growth will improve. I said, I am finance minister of a state, not of India. So why you are giving it to me? You should give it to Indian government finance minister or prime minister. So he told me, all of them told me a reason that Maharashtra is the most industrialized state. So this docket will tell you what is happening in the world and how you should also improve Maharashtra. The rules, regulations, and the decisions which are very essential for Maharashtra's economy and Maharashtra's growth rate apply to India also. So these rules, if you start in Maharashtra, where Maharashtra is the most industrialized state, probably India's growth rate, India's rank will come up in